Now for B, we have to calculate the enthalpy, delta H, in joules per mole for the formation of water. So here we have to figure out the enthalpy of water. So we're going to say delta H of reaction equals Q of solution divided by the moles of whatever they're asking us to find. Here they're asking for the formation of water, so it's moles of water. We already have half of this because we just figured out what the Q of solution was, so we just plug it in. Now what we have to do is we have to figure out how many moles of water we have. Now, what we should realize here is I give you information on NaOH and HCl. Remember, the word of, when it's in between two numbers, means multiply. And remember, when I say big M, that means molarity. Molarity equals moles over liters. So when I say 0.100 molar NaOH, that really means 0.100 moles of NaOH over 1 liter. We always assume it's always moles over liters. If you guys don't remember this too well, go back to a few videos past where we talked about molarity and molarity in stoichiometry. Because to do this question, it's essential that you remember those steps from earlier. So we're going to work it out down here. Okay. Since I give you information on two reactants, and I'm asking you how much product you have in moles, this is really a limiting reactant type of question. So we're going to have to first do it with the molarity of NaOH, see how many moles of water that gives us, then do the same thing with HCl. Since this is a limiting reactant type question, the one that gives us the smaller amount of moles of water, those are the moles we're going to use. So we have 50 mLs of 0.100 molar NaOH. I need to change my mLs into liters, so 1 mL on the bottom, 10 to the negative 3 liters on the top. mLs cancel out, and I finally isolate liters. Now that I have liters, I can multiply it times the molarity to find the moles of NaOH. Now, we need the moles of water though, so we need to go from these moles of given that we just found to our moles of unknown. And remember, when we do that jump, we do a mole-to-mole comparison. We look at the coefficients in the balanced equation. So, according to our balanced equation, for every 1 mole of NaOH, we have 1 mole of water. Okay, so NaOH on the bottom, and 1 mole of H2O, what we're looking for, on the top. Since this is in 10 to the negative 3, put it in brackets. When we work it out, we get 0.005 moles of water. Now we have to do the same thing with HCl. So we have 75 mLs of 0.100 molar HCl. So same thing, we change the mLs into liters first, then we multiply it times the molarity. Okay, and for every 1 mole of HCl, we have 1 mole of H2O. Liters cancel out, moles cancel out. So we have 0.0075 moles of water. Now remember, since this is a limiting reactant type question, we're going to go with the smaller moles of water. Those are the moles we're going to plug down here to find our enthalpy. So when we plug that in, we get back negative 2.73 times 10 to the 6 joules per mole. Now, this question had a lot of parts to it, and it became even harder because we had to incorporate concepts that we learned a few videos back. So, just because we passed molarity and stoichiometry involved with them doesn't mean we don't have to see it again this semester. Those types of ideas always resurface at some point. We had to use them in order to solve this question. Now remember, if we're at constant pressure, that's when we use a coffee cup calorimeter. And its whole purpose is to help us find the enthalpy of a reaction. Now remember, if your enthalpy, I may not have said that, but if your enthalpy is positive, that means you're absorbing energy or absorbing heat, so you're endothermic. And if you're releasing heat or releasing energy by the system, then it's exo, and it's negative delta H. So just remember the concepts that we covered here and the approaches we take. And so when you see a question like this, you'll be better prepared to do it.